The next thing we will do, let's go ahead and start a new one, is we'll go ahead and use our we'll go ahead and use our text tool here, right? So as you can see, if I click it again, it gives me options to auto group to basically bring your letters together and words together to form one box. I recommend doing that. So what I'll do once I select the letter is I'll hit the screen. And then that is what I'm texting. So what you can see probably right now is because the last time I used it, I used it with white text. So what I'm going to do on the very left here, first what I would have to do to change it though is I need to select all. But you could do this before. Let's actually just go ahead and start over. So I'm going to hit my color. And then this says stroke and fill. So I'm just going to go ahead and go with this this kind of red that came with explain everything. And then the fill, I could choose to make it like something else, right? I'm just going to leave it as white for now, though. Border. Do I want there to be a border around it? I could also change my fonts. I have fonts that are built for the operating system as well as for all just explain everything. So I'm going to just keep that one there. As you can see, there's plenty of fonts that you can choose from. I can change the size basically three different ways. I can make it smaller by hitting the little A, bigger by hitting the big A, or just hit that and I can have a little kind of wheel type of feel as I'm doing that. And then you have, right, your alignment, all of these things that you're probably familiar with using a text editor. Then I hit the check mark to kind of keep going. All right, so now here I have this. I can move it wherever I want with the hand tool. I could make it bigger and smaller using my two fingers, right, as well. And I can put that wherever I want. I can move it as part of my movement and what I'm trying to explain. So what's also really cool, which I really like, is I could actually multitask from, for example, notes and bring in text that way. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up the doc to do my multitasking. And then I'm going to bring up my notes. So let's bring on, let's see here. Let's bring in my notes. So these are my notes. You're seeing all my notes. All right. Let's bring in all my textual notes because that would be meta. All right. So I selected them there and I'm going to long hold and see how it pops out. And then I'm just going to bring it here. So I didn't even have to type it in. I didn't even have to copy and paste it in. I just brought it in that way. To get rid of this box, I'm going to just see the spark at the top. I'm going to slide down, and then I'm going to slide over from that bar on the side. Right, so I have that. So I can now edit that box, right, and say, okay, no, I don't want that to be red as well. I want that to be black. As you can see, it didn't change it because you know what I didn't do? I didn't select the actual text. Select all. Now I can change the color. All right, I can actually say now I do want there to be a fill and I want it to be pink. Not that pink. I'm gonna make it a little bit. There we go. Cool. All right, and I could use that as a way to use the text as well. That to me is a pretty good feature. All right, cool. Let me bring in. Let me bring in an image, and I'll just move these aside. We won't start fresh. We'll just bring in an image here. And we're going to talk about the cutout tool next. Let's go ahead and bring in one of these things. This is another image I got from Unsplash. Unsplash is great. Images you're able to use. Really cool stuff. It doesn't look... looks really good. But anyways, I digress. Let's now look at the cutout tool. So if I look down below where I have the text tool is my cutout tool. And so if I click it, I have three options, right? I have my rectangular cutout, my lasso cutout, and my precision cutout. All right. So my rectangular cutout, I'll let you guess what that means, right? So let's just say I am writing about... let's see, look at the sky. So with the cutout tool, right, I could take any portion of it and essentially it duplicates it. Now look, it's all of it, right? It did both text and part of the photo. And so that could be really good, especially if you're trying to duplicate. For example, when I was doing those gas molecules, let me go back to that. It might have been a good idea to have done that. The only thing I would say about doing it that way, instead of there's also a duplicate thing, is that it takes all of it, and as you can see, it's rectangular as well. So maybe it's not best for that use case, but you could do that, especially if you're using kind of a static image. You could use it that way. So let me bring that there. Okay, so I have that. And I just delete that for now. All right, which we haven't gotten to delete yet. But as you can see, if you click that, that will lead you to then touch things, which allows you to delete them. You can delete more than one thing at once. So you just touch and untouch to not delete them. See how there's only one X even though I have three things deleted? Right. All right. I got ahead of myself, but that's okay. Now let's go back to the cutout tool. And now I have my lasso. So I'm sure you can figure out what that means, right? So with my lasso tool, I can say maybe have this photographer who's getting a picture of him duplicated multiple times. I can do it again. All right, so now I have, for whatever reason, I might do that, right? So I now have four photographers being photographed, right? So the cutout tool basically cuts out and duplicates. But again, anything you cut out makes it one kind of piece. It flattens it. And so there are times that it makes sense to do that. There are times that it doesn't. Right. I'll let you kind of play with that and see that. The last one is the precise one, right, which gives you the kind of the X-Acto knife. You can flip, kind of see which direction you're coming from. You can move it around. So, for example, say I really want to get it real tight. So I could then, when I'm ready to, I'm going to hit the little X-Acto blade thing. All right. And then I essentially would then do this. All right. I could have zoomed in to do this as well, which probably what I would do if I was trying to make it real exact. And when I have what I really want exactly, I would then hit the check mark. And now I have number 5. This is definitely a boy band cover in the future. So if you want to use this cover for a boy band, I didn't get the shadows. Actually, that kind of makes it even a better photo if there's only one shadow. But anyways, that's how we use the cutout tool. I already explained just now how to use the delete tool. Here's another cool tool, the laser pointer. So I clicked it and then I clicked it again, right? And you have different options. You could use kind of like a hand thing. So I could have been doing this the whole time, but I didn't get to it yet. So right here's the shadow. I could do kind of, looks like vroom, 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 right? And this kind of looks like something you might use from a different movie, like Star Wars, different arrows, if you want to feel kind of like a computer, as well as if you actually wanted to kind of, not feel like a computer, but still have an arrow, you can do that as well. As well as just different laser pointers. They're fun. Cats don't like them as much, but anyways, I always tell that joke here at this point when I talk about explain everything.